inyo uli kanina. Ano po ang inyong reaksyon sa inyong nabasa?
Na lubha ho akong nabahala kasi itong December 13 pong resolution na ito at yung mga dissenting opinions na tanggap lang ho namin ito December 21. At sa unang pagkakataon, dun ho namin nalaman kung ano yung mga pangyayari, kaganapan sa loob ng Supreme Court ukol dun sa botohan ng tungkol dun sa issue ng effective na ba yung TRO. So, na masyado po akong nabahala na may mga irregularidad at meron hong mga, nung mga aspeto hong mga nabanggit ko kanina, kagagawan po ng Chief Justice.
Meron lang akong tanong ngayon, Madam Secretary.
Yes, Your Honor.
Kung yung mga kondisyones ng TRO na ipinababa ng Korte Suprema ay natupad sa inyong paniniwala, ay ang Department of Justice would have complied, di ba?
Ganito po, I beg your indulgence, Your Honor, but I think it's not as simple as that. I mean, the answer, I cannot just directly answer that. Okay, yung pangunahin ng dahilan kung bakit hindi ho namin sinunod yung TRO as of November 15, lalo na nung gabi na nagtangkang umalis yung dating pangulo, ay dahil nga po wala pang official copy. And then nakita ho natin as announced na may mga kondisyon. Now, sinabi ko rin po na nagulat ho nga kasi kami dun sa TRO because hindi namin po na hindi ho namin expected na mag-i-issue ng TRO na bibigyan muna dapat kami ng pagkakataon na i-explain kung bakit ayaw naming payagan yung dating pangulo na makaalis ng bansa. So ang sabi ko, we have to file a motion for reconsideration para maintindihan ng Korte Suprema yung mga naging dahilan kung bakit ayaw nating payagan yung dating pangulo. So sa pananaw ko po, pending the disposition or the resolution of the motion for reconsideration which was eventually denied by the Supreme Court on November 18, ay dapat po hindi na muna i-recognize yung TRO. Yun po ang naging position ko.
I will put it this way, so that I just want to clear all of this vague portions of this whole thing. If, and I'm giving a I'm asking a hypothetical question.
Yes, Your
Honor. If the TRO was served on the Department of Justice, being a necessary party, and if the conditions when the TRO was served had already been complied, would the Department of Justice have respected the TRO?
Maybe or maybe and maybe not. Your Honor, ang pananaw ko po kasi is that yung TRO po ay improper in the sense that a TRO, we know it, Your Honor, that it is supposed to preserve the status quo pending the disposition of the merits of the main petition. It is supposed to prevent something or to prevent the issues involved in the main petition from being moot and academic or rendered ineffectual. Yeah. Now, what was the effect of the issuance of the TRO, conditional or not? It had the effect of rendering the disposition of the main petition, well, illusory or ineffectual because it is as if you granted already the petition. Because the main issue really is, should we allow the former president to leave the country despite the pendency of these big cases against her? So nung pinayagan na po ng Korte Suprema na makaalis, ano pa po ba ang pag-uusapan natin? Parang na-preempt na yung magiging desisyon ng Korte Suprema. To me, Your Honors, in all honesty and based on my understanding of the law and the rules, hindi po yan ang function or office ng TRO.
You would have taken the steps to ask for a motion for reconsideration.
Exactly.
In order to really re-argue the necessity for a TRO and its effect.
Yes, Your Honor, that is why I immediately directed or requested the Office of the Solicitor General to file the urgent motion for reconsideration, which, as I said earlier, was denied in the subsequent session in November 18. Dinenay po yung aming motion for reconsideration. But on November 18 po, tamang-tama po, nagkaroon na ng resolution yung COMELEC dun sa electoral sabotage case, at ito ay final sa RTC Pasay at na-raffle nung bandang tanghali po siguro yon, or after lunch nung before lunch noontime of November 18, at na-raffle kay Judge Mupas, at nung mga bandang hapon po ay nakapagpalabas na si Judge Mupas ng warrant of arrest, and therefore naging moot and academic po yung usapin ng TRO dun sa consolidated cases before the Supreme Court.
But outside of all of this narrated information drawn from the dissenting opinion of Justice Sereno, did the Chief Justice alone or in combination with other members of the court acted alone in trying to enforce the TRO?
I would not have the information, or I'm not at all privy. And aside from those circumstances that were reflected in the dissenting opinion of Justice Sereno, Your Honor, I hindi ko na po yun alam. I'm not in a position to
Thank you, Madam Secretary, for your candor. The gentleman from Cavite.
Mr. President, with your respect, may I just...
By the way, are you through your honor?
I'll just put on record.
Let us let the prosecution to finish first. Yes, I'm sorry. I thought everything is over.
There's no problem, Mr. President. Yeah. I just would like to put on record that I have no further questions from the Secretary of Justice. Maraming salamat.
Proceed.
I have no more questions.
You have no more questions.
For now.